Laminar
versus Turbulent Flow by Dr. Robert Holzman.
Fluids or gas molecules moving through a tube under constant pressure separate into gradients of velocity profiles, with the fastest component in the center and the slowest components near the wall. When that cross-sectional area is reduced, the velocity has to increase, and therefore the pressure decrease, in order to maintain the same volume flow rate. Resulting gas flow will be much more turbulent. The flow of this fluid through the tube is proportional to the pressure gradient, the total pressure drop over the length of the tube, the fourth power of the radius of the tube, and inversely proportional to the viscosity of the fluid. This relationship is the Hagen-Poiseuille Law. The most important implication of this law is that halving the radius, for example, will decrease the flow rate to the fourth power, or 16-fold. Likewise, doubling the radius will increase the flow rate by 16-fold. This is critically important for infants and small children, especially, and explains the transformation of the clinical picture with appropriate treatment, for example, for croup. The efficiency of flow distal to this obstruction decreases because of a different physics equation, the fanning equation, for turbulent flow. This equation supersedes the Hagen-Poiseuille equation for laminar flow. This is where velocity in both equations is equal to the flow of the gas, P is equal to the pressure drop between proximal and distal portions of the obstruction, the R is the radius of the tube, the H or viscosity, and the L the length. The significance of that change in the expression from the flow rate to the square of the flow rate illustrates that a much greater driving pressure is required to maintain gas flow in a non-laminar flow situation. Note also that the power of the radius has to increase to accommodate the more turbulent and less efficient flow. With abrupt narrowing, complete separation of the stream profiles will occur, and the center stream constricts to a minimal value. The resulting turbulence may not be able to resume normal laminar flow.